If Excel is not recognizing your duplicates, there could be a number of reasons. Some of them relate to the actual tool or function in Excel, and some will relate to data. So here are the most common reasons we find. So the first one here, you can see I've got a whole bunch of numbers, and I've just used conditional formatting, and you can see that all of these are the same. Conditional formatting has noticed it. It's saying those are duplicates. Just be very careful. The remove duplicate tool does not see that. So for example, I'm going to highlight that. The only difference here is that this 5 has got two decimals, that one doesn't, and it's a number. So we're going to go to data, remove duplicates. I'm just going to unselect and say the duplicate is only here. So I expect only one number when I say okay. It says these are not duplicates. And similar here, you'll see an amount. This has got a dollar sign, that doesn't. Again, we're going to unselect all. This is on number 3. So you'll see in this case, the tool, you must be careful. Number formats must be exactly the same. The next reason, and this now relates to data, is spaces, leading and trailing spaces. So you'll see here, I've got a whole bunch of bank account numbers. I've shown the ones that are clearly duplicates. You can see those are duplicates, those are duplicates. I've done a COUNTIF to work out the duplicates, and here these are saying there's only one of them. It's not recognizing the two. If you look carefully, if you look in here, you can see there's an apostrophe and then there's a little space there. If I look at the next one, there's an apostrophe but no space here. But if I go to the end, can you see there's a space there? If I go to the third one, no apostrophe. So this is being seen as a number. So in this case, it's actually the data. So one way we like to test is we know this should be a duplicate. I should be able to go, I'm going to copy that, just paste as values here, and you'll see suddenly it's working. So in this case, I know there must be something different about this data, even if I'm not recognizing it. I'm just going to undo. So you need to sometimes look in your data and just see how it's come through, especially if that data is coming from multiple different systems. One system may put a space in the front, one at the end, and one of them actually may be recognized as numbers. In a similar vein, there's something here that we like to call almost spaces. So what you'll see here, I've got a whole bunch of student numbers, I've got a separate list, and I've built a COUNTIF just to say, how many times do you see this in this list? Now all the ones in green are here, and yet I'm being told 0. So if I look in here, that looks fine. If I look in here, also looks fine. So there's no obvious reason. So again, that useful test, copy it. I'm gonna just paste as values, replace it. And notice immediately I noticed it. I'm just gonna undo. So what it means is Excel is seeing something different here. Now, in this case, very important, a lot of systems are spitting it out like this. If I look at this space here, it's a bit difficult to tell, but if I highlight it, it seems to be a different size from this one here. So spacing can be a problem. This is a special type of space. I'm going to just highlight that one. I'm going to put a space with my keyboard in and notice it. So in this case, there's a spacing issue and you need to figure out which one you're going to make the same. You either need to replace these spaces with a normal space or perhaps remove the spaces. The next one is both related to the data and to actually the way functions work. So again, we've got our student numbers. I've done a VLOOKUP check, so I've built a VLOOKUP. I can clearly see it. I should actually see an answer, and yet I'm not. But when I do a COUNTIF, I actually get the right answers. So if we look at this one here, that looks fine. Notice there's a little apostrophe there. So Excel is seeing this as a number, and this has been forced to see as text. Let's just check. I'm going to copy this, paste as values here. And immediately you can see it's doing it correctly. I'm going to just undo. So what's interesting here is VLOOKUP, if it looks from a number to that exact same thing, but identified as text, it doesn't work. Whereas in this case, the count ifs did actually work. So in this case, you've got to be careful about both. But generally, take it, copy it, paste it. Did it work? Okay, there's something different about these two items. So in all the prior cases, it was an Excel issue, either the data or a tool or function. This one is more the user issue. So here again, I've got my duplicates. All these green ones should be duplicates. Only the first one is being noticed. So look at the formula you built. So I've got a count ifs here. So if you look like this, it's actually looking fine. Don't look where it's actually working. Come to one of these. I know this should be recognized. Let's see where it's looking. And you can see something's wrong with my formula. It's a very common error. There are no dollar signs here. So the way this formula should have been built, I'm just going to open it up, is this here, this area, should have dollar signs on it. I'm just going to put all my dollar signs on. When I say OK, you'll see now it works correctly. So have a look at your formula. Don't look at the ones that are recognizing. Look at some of the ones that aren't recognizing and see what's wrong with the formula. The next one, so we're not going to show it, just explain it. Power Query, very powerful tool. It's one big difference from Excel is that casing is considered a differentiator. So in this case, if in Power Query we said remove the duplicates based on the surname, even though in Excel these would all be seen as the same, because this one is all uppercase, all lowercase, and all proper case, these three would be considered different surnames. Same with this one. So if it's touching in Power Query, understand that this could be a problem, and in your actual queries, you need to probably force them to be consistent, so we make all our text uppercase.